Shine like the stars. Let's celebrate, 'cause it's a new day.
Spread the good vibes, meet someone happy today.
The world is opening up, it's time for a ride. Let's rise to the top. Forget, leave your worries behind. Let's talk and have fun, be together as one. Be who you are, be who you shine are. Like the stars, we'll be here with you. Let's make the whole world happy.
Be who you are,
be who you
shine
are.
Like the stars,
shine like the stars.
We'll be here with you. We're gonna make this world dance.
We're gonna make this world dance.
Kumusta, B-Fam? I'm your host, Bianca Gonzalez. And we give you a home away from home only here on BRGY. Tayo mga Pinoy, aminin natin, sobrang hilig natin sa mga artista. Siyempre, mga napapanood natin sa teleserye, sa pelikula, nakita natin sa social media. But behind these roles are real-life stories that are definitely worth telling. Today, we are going to be joined by a Kapamilya leading man who's about to share who he is beyond the actor we've come to love. Let's get real with Kapamilya actor who showed his talent and versatility through the years. Ngayon, handa na siyang iparinig naman ang kanyang bagong regalo sa ating lahat. Ano kaya yon? Let us welcome to BRGY, the one and only Ian Veneracion!
Hello!
Hello again! Welcome!
It's nice to be here. Thank you for inviting me.
Yes, thank you also for your time. Kamusta? Congratulations on the release of the new music.
Thank you. It's been released a few days ago.
How does it feel? Kasi you've been working on your music for months. And ngayon, it's out in the world. Anong nararamdaman?
Wala. Para, it's like, you know, like your babies and then go fly. and then see what happens. Saka nakakatawa, syempre, when people message you na, oh, I heard your song, I really like it.
Yeah, and that's what it's all about.
Yes.
Diba? And I think through your music, through your roles, through your art as well, diba, yun naman ang pinaparamdam mo sa ibang tao. Pero, ba-backtrack tayo dito kung paano tayo napunta sa album na ito, because you've loved music since you were younger.
Kid, yes.
As in because of the influence of your dad.
Parang required kami noon to take up lessons. So naalala ko na minsan galing akong football, tapos didiretso ako sa piano lessons ko na nahiinis ako nung bata ako kasi parang obligasyon lang eh. Tapos, nung time na yun kasi wala pa namang internet,
mm-hmm.
So ang hirap matuto. Yung magazines dati na, yes. Na may chords. Tapos doon ko na-enjoy kasi parang, okay, so may chords pala. First time ko na pwede ko pala tugtugin kung anong gusto ko. I'm alone but I can recreate the music. Doon siguro nag-start yung interest ko din with music.
Right now, babalikan natin ng ilan sa mga most memorable roles ni Ian in his life, and we'll show you pictures and we'll talk about it. So first, I think you probably have a guess kung ano yung first photo na lagi ipapakita, but that of course is... Yeah.
Okay.
Ito talaga yung, kumbaga, 80s, 90s, just, babies would know.
Alam mo, hindi ko pa rin maintindihan hanggang ngayon. Who would watch an action movie na ang lead 15-year-old guy? Anyway, so it did well and nasundan siya ng maraming action movies. So that's a milestone in my career.
Yun nga yung inisip ko, kung 15 ako tapos parang ganyan ang trabaho ko, it will really feel like playing. So
yes.
I was curious, at what point in your acting career did you really feel like, oy, work na pala to and work that I love doing?
When I was 13, I did Hiwaga sa Paleto Drive with Direk Pere Gallaga and Direk Lori Reyes.
Mm.
And then I found myself on the set na ang ka-eksena ko, Joel Torre, Gina Alahar, Charito Solis.
Wow.
So ako yung parang sobrang na-intimidate kasi, oops, what am I doing here? To me, acting before was like just pretending. Yun, dun ako na-inspired, tapos nakita ko yung process nila. And then I realized na hindi pala, actually baliktad. It's not pretending. You're going for authenticity, actually. You're going for real emotions. Kasi the first person you have to convince is yourself. Bago mo ma-convince yung audience mo. Sobrang na-enjoy ko na kasi I get to live many, many lives.
Wow.
So that's what opened my appreciation to the craft.
Yun pala ang proseso ng isang Ian Veneracion. And it's great na na-experience mo siya early on. There is another photo that we wanted to share with you, another iconic role of Ian, and that of course is us.
Oh, yeah. Eduardo. Uy, tama-tama, wala akong bigote ngayon.
Ibang look. Ibang look. Grabe, no? So this was in 2015. This was already the remake of Pangako Sa'yo,
yes,
where DJ and Kath played Ina, yes, and Angelo. And I think what was so pivotal, I don't know if that's the right word, about this project as well, is feeling ko kayo ni Jody ang nagpabuhay ulit ng love themes not in the teen
nang mature
era.
Love story.
Yeah.
And really, we didn't expect that. Akala namin sa simula lang yung you know, when laying out the context of the narrative na parang, oh, sige, ngayon lang tayo busy. Pero pagtapos ito, chill na tayo. Kasi andyan na yung mga bagets. Mm. Pero for some reason, kinapitan din ng mga tao yung storya na mature love story. So yun, so hindi rin kami nakapahinga. Dire-diretso din, dire-diretso lahat. It was very challenging doing that series. Pero yun nga, it opened up the na-realize ng marami na ang dami palang, may clamor din pala for mature love stories aside from the teenage love at first sight, you know, the usual.
What did it feel like at that point of your career? You've been acting for several decades by that time, na parang nagkaroon ulit ng kilig type love team fan base.
Strange. Super strange.
They would tag you kasi, di ba, on social media, make parang fan videos, fan edits.
Yeah, pero I was accepting, you know, guest roles, yung mga guesting lang na role or supporting. Parang naka-mindset ako na I'll be doing this for the rest of my life as an actor. Actor lang talaga. Pero not as a, you know, celebrity.
Okay, we have a last photo to share with you. And ito possibly ang pinaka-important role in Ian's life.
Ay,
gusto ko yung solo pick. Oh, pero this signifies a real-life family man. You were talking about privacy earlier and you are one of those celebrities, actors, public personalities who are able to keep a very private life.
Private and
intentional yun.
And simple life. Mm. Yeah. I mean, most of my friends are non-showbiz. Buong family ko wala namang showbiz. And sa akin yung shooting, yung work, it's just work.
You have always enjoyed nga your private life and your boundaries. And I was curious kasi for a lot of people know that you are talagang the cool dad, di ba? To your kids, you're very supportive.
You mean the consentidor dad?
The cool dad,
yeah.
Yun. The cool dad.
But ako yung panganay.
Did they never want to enter showbiz? Kasi technically, it would be easier for them because they're
ako,
of your
I never wanted them to enter showbiz. Kasi I appreciate the fact that I entered showbiz, walang padrino, wala akong kilala. So I was forced to know my stuff, to do my homework, to read the script, and I was forced to be marunong makisama, to be kind, to be professional, to be on time. Kung hindi ka mabait o hindi ka magaling o hindi mo alam yung lines mo,
bye-bye.
Ang dami nakapila dyan, di ba? And that helped me, and that's where I get my confidence from also.
Mm.
Na, kumbaga, I know my stuff. Yung ganun.
Pinaghirapan mo talaga.
Oh, pinaghirapan mo. And yun ang gusto ko na ma-experience nila. I feel like, pag may anak ako na nag-artista, syempre, hindi ko matitiis. Tatawagan ko yung mga kilala natin. Ng mga,
as a parent.
Cast mo naman dyan, ano? Bagay dyan siya, ano? Cast mo naman siya. Or kunin mo naman. Yung ganun. Yeah. Or iba yung treatment ibibigay sa kanila kasi anak ko. Yung ganun. So, para ko silang dineprive nung sarili lang adventure.
It's great to know na as a parent, dun ka sa kung ano yung gusto nila.
Importante na, eh, kasi di ba, you only live once nga. So parang ayokong pilitin sila sa bagay na pwede rin naman sila mag-fail. Might as well magsugal ka dun sa gusto mo. Para mag-fail ka man, okay lang. At least silbuha mo. Yeah. Diba?
Gandang mindset nun, di ba? And speaking of YOLO, you are known to be really YOLO sa iba't ibang mga extreme activities, extreme sports, maliban sa acting and sa music. Ang dami-dami pang hilig ni Mr. Ian Veneracion, and we are going to talk about that when we return here on BRGY. You are still with me, Bianca Gonzalez. Let's continue to be real with Ian Veneracion. Okay, bukod sa acting and music, like we said, ang daming iba't ibang gustong gawin ni Ian, especially in your free time. Like you said, you like to enjoy your freedom. So we're gonna show you a few pictures and we're gonna talk about it.
Sure.
Okay, first is isa sa mga outlets, form of self-expression ni Ian ay ang painting.
My father kasi is a painter.
Yes.
So he does that every single day. And so maaga pa lang, lagi akong kasama kami ng sister ko tsaka ng brother ko. Lagi kami kasama sa mga art exhibits ng mga friends niya. So maaga kami na-expose dun. Pag makulit din ako, inaabutan ako ng dad ko ng canvas tsaka, or papel tsaka paint para hindi ko siya kulitin.
So, smart.
Tapos, eventually, when I had kids na, I wanted them to see also. So I introduced art to them in a way na chronological also. I brought them to the Paul Getty Museum in LA para Renaissance muna, how it started and what were they were doing during those times. Without context kasi, when you see modern art, for example, ang daling sabihin na, ay, kaya ko din yan eh. Ano, what's so special about this? Winisik-wisik lang yan eh. So yun, doon ko dinala yung kids ko in that chronological para meron silang context. And I guess it worked kasi they love art, different forms of art.
Oh, di ba meron tayong express lesson on art? And we'd like to marry this conversation with music as well. Kasi I'm sure that you do listen to some sort of music while you paint, while you create. Anong klaseng sounds, anong genre, anong playlist ang preferred mo when you paint?
Kahit ano, pero nai-influence nun yung kalalabasan ng painting. For example, I have a blank canvas, tapos nakinig ako ng Red Hot Chili Pepper. May lalabas na pagka-Red Hot. Eh, alam yung nadadamay ka sa vibe nung kanta.
Yeah.
So, yun ang lalabas. And I think I can do also the other way. I can, kumbaga, I can look at a certain image.
And
parang lalagyan mo ng scoring.
Yeah.
Tapos lalagyan mo siya ng, kung if it were expressed in sound, how would it sound like?
Yeah.
Yung ganun. Tapos, parang ganun. So, it's interchangeable, I think.
You've had several solo exhibits. Do you plan to do one again soon?
The last exhibit I had was, I had to rent a house for 6 months.
Oh, to create.
And nakakulong lang ako dun, like a monk with a coffee maker, coffee machine. Empty space. Just canvas, paint, all my stuff.
Yeah.
Tapos, kaya lang, para akong hinihigop ng rabbit hole.
Yeah.
I can see myself getting lost there in that world talaga.
Yeah, artist's mind ka talaga. We have a next photo here that I'd like you to, you said kasi kanina, when you see an image, you can hear a song or match a song to it. So, this next photo that we'll show you, yan, flying.
Sa Sydney to.
If there was a song or soundtrack you'd like to put on that image.
Ano? Yung sound ng Top Gun. Highway to the danger zone. Feeling Top Gun.
Yeah. No, although, Top Gun talaga. Legit. Actually, very Tom Cruise ng Pilipinas naman talaga si Ian. Alam natin yan because you are also a licensed pilot and you're licensed for many other extreme sports and extreme things.
This flight, I remember, it was in Sydney and we flew over Sydney Opera House. And there was a paragliding site. I flew beside it, tapos nakikita ko yung mga paragliders, and sobrang enjoy.
So from the air, we will now go to the sea with the final photo that we would like to show you. Isa sa mga activities that you love doing in the water, which you really love, is... There
sailing.
There you go.
Sailing with my babies.
Yun ang sinabi mo.
Yun, nag-enjoy ako pag sila, marunong sila, they can sail.
Oh, really?
That's a 33-foot trimaran, pero I set it up in such a way na lahat ng lines would lead to you that you can drive it alone. Mas natututo ako actually pag kailangan ko silang turuan. For example, paragliding. Kung ako lang, alam mo na kung kontento ka na sa alam mo.
Yeah.
Kasi pwede na eh.
Yeah.
Pero pag biglang kailangan kong turuan yung anak ko, I have to do a lot of research and, di ba?
Yeah.
I'm forced to know the dangers, how the procedure. Kasi I want it to be safe for my child.
Mm-mm.
So, nakaka-speed up din ang learning process ko pag tinutuan ko sila. Dahil mga bata, napakabilis nila matuto. What takes me, I don't know, a year or a couple of years, takes them like 3 months.
Mm-mm.
And then later, sila na yung nagsasabi sa ina, hindi, dapat kasi ganito ginagawa mo eh. Oh, I like that. Thank you. Ganun.
Galing ng bonding activity nila, no? Parang hindi your usual mall, movie, saka na talaga mga outdoor activities.
Eh kasi activities. Nga, ang swerte natin, nakatira tayo sa pinakamagandang... Yes. I mean, geographically, the most beautiful place
totoo
on earth.
Totoo naman. To tie it back in, what song or soundtrack would you give to that photo?
Sailing. Christopher Cross. Pwedeng cover. Ayan, Christopher
Cross.
Sailing.
Literal. Gusto ka yun. Yeah, 90s babies know the song. Yeah. Ako yung mga Gen Z, alam nyo pa ba yun? I-look up nyo. Beautiful song. Oo. At syempre, because you tied all your experiences and I guess naging thread talaga siya sa buhay mo, ang music, we cannot end this conversation without talking with your new music out. So Ian's gonna talk about his new project and his brand new album and singles out when you return here on BRGY. And you're still with me, Bianca Gonzalez, and our very special guest, Ian Veneracion. There you go. Okay, you have loved music for so long. You love like writing and doodling and like strumming on the guitar. Pero what was it that made you say, I think it's time to release an album, to create an album?
It started with A Love to Last. Kasi dati sobrang nahihiya akong kumanta. And it started there where in role ko nga composer and sabi ko I have no problems with the piano and the guitar pero the singing part nakahiya. And because I approached it as an actor.
Ah, like what you said kanina, so hindi siya playing a role,
oh,
it's
so
you.
So kailangan, hindi ako mahiya, kailangan nag-enjoy ako. So, narealize ko, parang kumapal na yung mukha ko after that. Gusto ko na kumanta lagi.
Alam ikaw na ang pinipigilan na kumanta.
Yung mga sa video ko na ayaw kumanta, yes. Pero pag nakahawak ng mic, hindi na bumibitaw.
Yes.
Ayan, isa pala
ikaw
ako doon. Kasama
I'm
pala
sure
ako doon.
I'm sure relate kayo doon.
So, yun, na-enjoy ko na. And parang like how I approach other mediums of expression. Alam mo yung ayoko yung art with a capital A na natutunan ko yung kay Direk Peke. Na for example, you wanna sing? Can you just sing? Pero minsan, di ba, parang, eh, hindi ako singer eh. Hindi ka naman kailangan mag-singer para mag-enjoy ka ng kumanta. I mean, just sing. And then, hindi mo naman kailangan maging songwriter para sumulat ng kanta. Hindi ko tingin sa sarili ko, hindi naman ako painter. Pero I really enjoy painting. Hindi naman ako professional photographer, but I love photography and stuff like that. So, ganun din with songwriting and with playing the music. Ganung approach lang. Para wala rin pressure because I'm not pretending to be this or that. That's how I'm approaching also music and even acting. Alam mo, up to now, I see myself as a working actor. Parang I don't want to see myself as a celebrity. Kasi
until
it gets
now.
In the way. It gets in the way of the craft. It gets in the way of the job. Kasi pag nakita ko, ay, ang pangit ko pala umiyak. Mamaya, ganito gagawin ko. Ay, yung pala yung angulo ko, ah, dapat ganito. You become result-oriented. Mm. And it gets your attention away from the process and just instead of just being there and ano, bahala na kayo, kunan nyo yung kung ano man gagawin.
Ayaw mo maging self-conscious in any art that you do. Gusto mo lang i-enjoy yung proseso.
Yes, kasi I don't want to be caught up in the BS. Because nag-iipon tayo ng BS eh.
Mm-hmm. Tama. And speaking of BS, that is the very spicy title of your album and Act 1 with 3 songs is now out. How come that is your chosen title?
Because it's in the context of me. I had to get above and beyond my BS that I've accumulated through the years and stop saying, yun na, na parang, hindi. Kung gagawa ako ng song na gustong makinig ng tenga ko, maybe may gustong makinig, maybe wala, does it matter? No. O sige, I'll still record the song and maybe makikinig to ng mga apo ko sa tuhod in, you know, in year, ano, so 50 years from now, 100 years from now. Yun, so in that context lang, without consideration na marami kayo makakagusto nito or kikita kaya to, may commercial success, yung ganun.
Because this is Act 1, does that necessarily mean makaka-asa sila ng Act 2,
definitely.
Act 3?
Definitely, Act 2 is already there. Act 3 is already there. Act 4 is actually already there. Baka hanggang Act 25 po.
Wow.
You know, well, yun nga, I just keep on recording. And I'm just embracing it while the creative flow is there and while it's easy now with the group of people I'm working with.
Yeah,
hindi pa naman kami pumapalya. Pero that makes me think also, maybe we're not pushing it too much.
Madami pa namang acts, so makikita mo in the future acts.
I'm sure.
Kung mangyayari
one of these days, sasablay kami, malungkot kami kasi mas ma-hurt yung ego namin at pride namin kasi pumunta tayo with nothing, we ended up with nothing.
Baka meron pa kasi kayang overflow, kaya yun ang lumalabas. But right now, everyone who loves Ian as an actor can experience Ian as a musician with 3 songs out right now on
yes.
Act 1. If ever, to encourage all of them to stream it right now on their devices. Yes, o diba? Siyempre, nandiyan yung guitar for a reason. So, let's see which of the 3 songs Ian's gonna play today.
So, meron itong tahana. Nung nire-record namin, gusto namin yung parang may heartbeat. So, sa studio, yun yung ginagawa ng drummer, ganun parang heartbeat. Anyway, the song goes something like this. Gising sa umaga, di ka na nakita. Ang hirap maniwala. Tapos ang chorus niya, ito, isipin mo kung kailan mo nararamdaman yung ganito. Ang chorus niya. Tama na, tama na, ayoko na. Kailan mo nararamdaman yun?
Ako,
pag puyat na puyat ka na o pag sinabi sa yung, oy, mayroon pa tayong 5 episodes, ha? Pero nakalima ka na, tapos sasabihin sa'yo, oh, 5 na lang ang guest natin. Ganon?
Hindi. Na-imagine ko yan, aminin nyo, na-imagine nyo to, pinapakinggan namin yun habang nagkakape. Tapos umuulan-ulan sa labas. When you made me hear it for the first time, that's what I...
Oh, nice.
Kape pa rin.
Oh, at least,
so baka nagkakape ka when you're writing
yes,
it.
Yes,
so,
at least pleasant pa rin.
Yes, pleasant.
Pleasant pa rin.
Pleasant. Yeah. Oh, di ba yan ang behind-the-scenes story yeah. of the song. And it's wonderful to get to hear yung proseso, pati yung mga side comments and side stories tungkol sa kanta. Congratulations
thank
on Act
so
1
much.
Being out and thank you for being here on BRGY. Palakpakan natin.
Thank you.
Mr. Ian Veneracion. Yes! Kung gusto nyo marinig in full at mag-emote-emote with your kape at home, stream it now. Yes, please do invite everyone
yes.
to listen to
it's
your
available
music.
On all the platforms now. Wow, all the platforms.
Yes.
You know, all the major platforms lang. It's called, pag sinearch mo yata, ENV.
Yes.
ENV, Beyond BS, the songs Maybe, Tahana, and Nahihilo Ko. And check it out and see if it resonates with you.
Yes. Again, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you so much.
I'm sure mas nakilala niyo si Ian beyond his just being an actor. Napakaraming facets and I'm sure na inspire kayong lahat. But of course, you are allowed to say you do have a acting project coming soon. Are
yes, I'm excited about it. We've been training heavily because it's an action-packed series.
Yes.
Hindi ko masabi pa yung title at yung cast. Pero
it's so exciting. The cast, guys, grabe.
Exciting.
Yeah.
Solid siya. Even the locations kung sa kami mag-shoot. It's a big project.
Yes. Yeah. Congratulations and good luck with that.
Thank you.
Once again, thank you. And eto na sa ating mga kapamilya abroad. Hindi natin patatapusin ng episode na to without our BRGY shoutouts. We'd like to say hi to our global Pinoys. Sunny Nahera from San Francisco na magbabirthday this Sunday. Happy birthday to you. Kathy Agtang from Abu Dhabi and Ronil Reyes from Abu Dhabi. Would you like to greet anyone around the world, family, friends?
All our kababayans na mga nakasalamuha ako na the past couple of years touring. The kababayans from Hawaii, from Switzerland, from Lucerne, from Vancouver, Toronto. Sobrang swerte natin kasi nagkalat ang Pilipino
yes.
sa buong mundo. And, you know, I love doing that, going to our kababayans and performing for them. Hopefully,
yes.
this year, I hope to visit all of you.
Yes, hopefully. And with his very own original songs
this
time.
Yes, for a change.
I love that. And if you also want to give a shout out to your own BFAM, san man yan sa mundo, all you have to do is comment on our TFC Facebook page at malay nyo, sila na ang susunod na mabati dito sa BRGY. If you want to rewind and replay lahat ng mga stories ni Ian or even his songs, you can do that by rewatching our episodes. Just go to the Filipino channel on YouTube and search for BRGY. We also have bonus uncut versions. Of course, we're also on I Want TFC where you can watch your favorite Kapamilya shows anytime, anywhere. And we also invite you to subscribe, syempre, sa ating social media pages ng TFC for exclusive content and updates on events brought to you by the Filipino channel. Once again, Ian Veneracion, a big round of applause, everyone!
Thank you. Thank you.
This has been Bianca Gonzalez giving you a home away from home only here on BRGY. It's time for a ride. Let's rise to the top.